Now you're older and I look at your face. Every wrinkle is so easy to place. And I only write them down just in case that she died. Let's take a look at these crow's feet. Just look. Sitting on the prettiest lines. 60/25th of December. 59th 4th of July. Take a good look at this cross feet sitting on the pretty side.
Good morning, happy Saturday.
Do you know what's really annoying? When you run out of shaving foam. I literally shaved one leg this morning and then no more foam came out the can.
Right, well, it's pretty obvious that this room is a mess. It's Saturday, so we're going to do some cleaning, aren't we, Charlie? We're going to move that desk over to this side.
That's really to do with the cage, because Charlie keeps getting out of the door that's broken on his cage. So we're going to move him back over to that side.
I'm also going to buy some paints to match the rest of the furniture, so I'm going to paint that little cabinet over there, because it's all patchy and bleh. Okay, Mark, so you're making yourself a smoothie. What have you put in it?
It's got oats, honey, baby spinach, banana, peanut butter, and dark chocolate chips.
I got my chocolate in the end. Okay, what are you adding here? Protein?
Just one scoop.
Okay. Okay. Need to give this toasted sandwich maker a good clean. It's so grotty now. Definitely need to clean it. Voila!
One great advantage of having a tiny little car at the moment is that I can get into really tight spaces.
I mean, that is a pretty tight spot that I have just skillfully reversed into. Boys, take note of your mother's incredible parking.
Maybe I should go back to having a small car.
Only kidding, that is not going to happen.
Back in the car, Boots gave me this massive bag, even though I've only got like four small items.
Yeah, so I got myself, well, I got these tissues for Connor. And I've got my shaving foam. Yeah, you can do me other leg now. Some Sanctuary Spa soap, because that is my favourite. I just love that brand. And some Florence by Mills Dewy Moisturiser. And a nude lipstick.
A nude lipstick is an absolute makeup staple. We're watching the Britain's Got Talent finals! Woo! So, if you were putting money on an act to win tonight, who would it be on?
Jon Courtenay.
Jon Courtenay.
Jon Courtenay.
He's going to win it.
You think Jon Courtenay? I think Steve Royal should win it. I would love him to win it.
Okay, it's Damien O'Brien.
I've been holding this phone and talking about your memories. Great. One last one. Inside this box of memories are a few of my favourite moments from my time here on BGT.
Did you find him?
Amanda, yeah. And lands on your phone and onto my social media.
Okay.
Just scroll up.
He's doing a kind of Instagram trick here.
You'll see there's a picture.
Should we just...
Yeah,
it is actually there on his Instagram.
No way!
Oh my gosh!
It's a card.
Wow. How is he doing this?
One more memory tonight.
I'm so confused.
Amanda, where's your phone?
I don't know. You're not going to smash it.
No way. Is Amanda's phone inside the box? No way. Not the best moment for the food to arrive. my gosh. Wow. Hey, Steve Royal, the comedian. Ha ha. I hope he's good.
Which is the greater?
This is such slapstick humour. Yeah, this guy was really good. He just did a disappearing act in a box and then reappeared on the other side of the stage. Aww, James and Dylan Piper just did a really clever trick.
Please read it out loud so everyone can hear.
Aww.
Strong.
Aww, that's amazing. How on earth do they do these predictive magic tricks, man? That's just so clever. Oh my gosh! Wow! This is so amazing. They totally deserve to be in the top three.
I won't get any better from the night and from the magicians and from you guys. You're the one act that I really, really wanted to be here tonight, and this is why.
Your life don't get much bigger than this. It's a milestone like a wedding or a teenager's first kiss. It's happy when they're playing, having fun. I wasn't happy when the schools closed and I had to teach my son.
Yes! Brilliant, John! Oh my gosh, Jon Courtenay just won Britain's Got Talent. That's fantastic. That's fantastic.
Yes, I had a particular invested interest in the Britain's Got Talent finals tonight because I had a couple of bets placed. Now, if Steve Royal had won it, I would have won £800, which would have been lovely. Yes, it would have been, wouldn't it, Charlie? But I also had a little flutter on Jon Courtenay to win it, and I placed the bet some time ago. So that netted me tonight his win, £300. Woo! I'm so relieved. It's not anywhere near like a life-changing sum of money, but it does cover the expenses for getting the Yaris back on the road, like the insurance deposit and the tax and everything. So now I can pay myself back. The other side, I actually really wanted Jon Courtenay to win. I thought he was the best act, even though the others were really, really good. I just felt that Jon just had the edge, the way he summed up the coronavirus and everything, and the positive attitude that he had in that final song. Oh my gosh, yeah, he just totally deserved it. So well done, Jon Courtenay.